Story of another journalist being attacked, this time in Kerala, where a senior journalist, Sajeev Gopalan, was brutally assaulted by cops late Sunday in front of his daughter and wife. Sajeev was admitted in a government hospital near Varkala with serious head injuries. Sources say that the cops allegedly hit back after the journalist reported a story where two women were kidnapped and the police allegedly submitted a report in favor of the accused. This, of course, coming just a week after Asianet office was attacked.
ഈ രണ്ട് പോലീസുകാർ എന്നെ നല്ല രീതിയിലങ്ങ് അടിക്കുക ഇവിടെ ഇട്ടിട്ട് അപ്പോൾ ആൾക്കാരെല്ലാം കണ്ട് ആരും അടുക്കുന്നുമില്ല പെട്ടെന്ന്. ഇതിനിടയിൽ ഒരു പോലീസ് താഴെ ഇറങ്ങിയിട്ട് പറഞ്ഞ് ഫോൺ ചെയ്യുന്നു എസ് ഐ വർക്കല വാസ് വിമല തിയേറ്ററിനടുത്ത് സാധാരണഗതിയിൽ രാത്രി അവിടെ കൊണ്ടിടും. അപ്പോൾ അവിടെ നിന്ന് പെട്ടെന്ന് വന്നു രണ്ട് മിനിറ്റ് കൊണ്ട് ഓടി വരുന്നു. ഞാൻ വണ്ടി ഇരുന്ന് ഗേറ്റ് കൂടെ കയറി ഓടി വന്നിട്ട് അവ എവിടെയെന്ന് പറയുമ്പോൾ ഞാൻ അവിടെ എപ്പോൾ ഞാനും എൻ്റെ വൈഫും എൻ്റെ മോളും നിലവിളിക്കുക, നമ്മൾ അടിക്കല്ലേ ഓടി വരട്ടേ പറഞ്ഞു. അപ്പോൾ ആൾക്കാർ കൂടി വരുമ്പോൾ തന്നെ ഈ ഓടിക്കൊണ്ടു ഈ എസ് ഐ വന്നിട്ട് കയറിപ്പിച്ചു. അടി എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ ആദ്യത്തെ അടിയെന്ന് ഇവിടെ ഒക്കെ തന്നെ അടിച്ചത്. എൻ്റെ കണ്ണാടി ചെറിയ മിനി ഗ്ലാസ് ഉണ്ട്, അതങ്ങ് പൊട്ടിങ്ങ് തറയിപ്പോയി. പ്ലാസ്റ്റിക്കും ഗ്ലാസും കൂടെ ചേർന്നൊരു മിക്സ്, അതങ്ങ് പൊട്ടി തറ വീണു. അപ്പോൾ എൻ്റെ വൈഫ് കിടന്ന് വിളിച്ചു പറയും, സാറേ എൻ്റെ ഭർത്താവ് എന്ത് തെറ്റ് ചെയ്തു, മദ്യപിച്ചിട്ടുണ്ടോ, ഒന്നുമില്ലല്ലോ, നിങ്ങൾ പറ എന്തിനാ എൻ്റെ വീട്ടിനകത്ത് പോയി, ആരെങ്കിലും പരാതി ഉണ്ടോ. ഇല്ല, ഈ അടിക്കുന്ന കൂട്ടത്തിൽ ഒറ്റ സെൻറ്റൻസ് എസ് ഐ പറഞ്ഞത് വായി എന്ന് വന്നതാണ്. ഇടവേല അവളുമാരെ വാർത്ത നീ കൊടുക്കൂടാന്ന് ചോദിച്ചു. ഞാൻ അപ്പോഴും അന്തം വിട്ടുപോയി. ഞാൻ അതുപോലും ഈ വീട്ടിൽ പറഞ്ഞില്ല ഏത് വാർത്ത നമ്മൾ കൊടുക്കുന്നത്, അത് ഡിസ്കസ് ചെയ്യാറില്ല. ഇത് ചോദിച്ചപ്പോൾ എനിക്ക് മനസ്സിലായി ഇതെന്തോ ഒരു പ്ലാനിങ് പരിപാടിയാണ്. അല്ലെങ്കിൽ അവർ ഇത്ര കണ്ണിങ് ആയിട്ട് ഇവൻ വന്ന് ഓടി വന്ന് തന്നെ അടിക്കേണ്ട കാര്യമില്ലായിരുന്നു ഈ എസ് ഐ.
Indeed, very shocking incident that happened yesterday in Varkala, where a senior journalist, as you said, was brutally assaulted in front of his family members. Now, this incident happened yesterday night at around 10:30 p.m. When Sajeev Gopalan, his wife and his daughter was just moving out of his house with his relatives. Two policemen came in a two-wheeler and started assaulting Sajeev Gopalan without any provocation. And when this went on for some time, Sajeev Gopalan asked us, what is the reason? They had not uttered a single word, and then they called up the SI in the phone, and the SI Biju Kumar came at the spot. Even he kept smashing, he kept on hitting him in his head and his nose and on his body. He was being scuttered down, and he was also scuffled, and he was hit multiple times, and there was blood coming, blood stains all over his face, and he was taken to a government hospital nearby. What I understand from the sources from the newspaper Kerala Kaumudi is that Sajeev has been following a story. He has been with a story where the police has been clearly on the back foot, where two young girls were abducted, were kidnapped, and they were in the confinement of a person. And later, the police itself has submitted a report which is basically supporting the accused. Now, this is what Sajeev Gopalan has questioned. Now, he was exactly doing his job in this case, and that is the reason he's been targeted. Now, as you said, it's the second attack on the media house just in a week's time. Last week, we reported the same story here in Mirror Now 2, where Asianet office was attacked in Alappuzha. Even that was for the same reason. In this case, the police officials were, it was on the police officials on the receiving end. But on the other side, it was a transport minister of Kerala who was on the receiving end. Oh no, that is what which is seemed to be provoking in that case. But in this case, it was the police clearly in the dock. Now, the Kerala Trivandrum Press Club has complained to the complaint cell of the Kerala police and also registered a complaint with the Human Rights Commission. The DGP has assured stringent police action in this case. But till now, it is very surprising that even after those people who are the witness, that is his wife and his kid and his family members, giving a statement about those people who were involved in this crime, not even a single arrest has been made till now. And that is even shocking. And that too in a place like Kerala.
Well, like we told you last week, it was the Asianet news office that was also attacked by some miscreants in Kerala. At that time, the chief minister had ordered a probe into the Asianet attack. But till now, we do not have an update as to what action has been taken or what the probe really has thrown up as far as the attack on the Asianet TV news office is concerned. And now, just a week later, we have seen this attack take place on a print journalist. The big question is, what is the chief minister going to do, as repeatedly the media in his state is targeted and attempts are made to silence the journalist Sajeev Gopalan, a print journalist who recently did a story where he spoke about a case of two women being kidnapped and then questioned the police investigation that favored the accused in the case. Just days after that, this is his state in the hospital with multiple injuries. His family, this was done to him in front of his family. But the cops right now haven't taken any action against those policemen who thrashed him.